I'm looking forward to the sound of this one. Here we go. If you're listening on BBC Radio Jersey, you'll be hearing a wonderful sound in a moment. If you are on the seafront here, you'll have seen it already. Look out between Lisbon Castle and the harbour. Here comes the Mustang.
Oh, what a fantastic sight.
Fantastic noise.
So, of course, the Mustang was a wonderful example of what could have been becoming what it should have been. It was originally designed in 1940 as a result of British Purchasing Commission request to the United States for fighters. North American Aviation were told to go away and build the Curtis P-40. They said, nah, hang on a minute, I can make something better than that, mate. In American, of course. And they designed in just 139 days the P-51 Mustang. And a legend was almost born, because as it came along, first of all, it had the Allison engine. And it ran out of thrust at about 12,000 feet, which is typical, because the Commission 109 is a flight higher. So somebody had a great idea of what would happen if we put a Merlin onto the Mustang. And a legend is born. That's the engine you made the helicopter, of course. Here it is, the Mustang up in the clouds above us here, instantly in fame. And what a wonderful sound this thing makes. Mustang pilot during the Second World War. He flew cargo escorts for the bombing raids over into Germany and occupied Europe. And they managed to squeeze in all 6 foot 1 of them into this aircraft with pilot Nigel Mann, and took off. Peter then was a very elderly man, it's safe to say. And the pilot was gone, and he was sent off to fly out, as you say, 1,000 feet or so, and then come back and down. Okay. Well, off it went. The next thing we were flying about 50 feet over the runway in Jersey, upside down, with a very, very happy former RAF pilot on board. What a wonderful thing to do. He was as happy as a soundboy when he got out, that's for sure. What a wonderful aeroplane this was, extensively used for fighter escorts during the Second World War, for bomber escort, I should say, taking the bombers over to Germany and fighting off the attacking fighters as they came along. And not perhaps as sexy looking as a Spitfire, but what a performance level. Indeed, that whistle we can hear as it goes up is the noise of the air rushing through the gun ports, going down the gun barrels out of the empty cartridge area, because that is like a, it's like a sort of a pipe organ effect as it's going. It's the guns that are making that whistling sound. But a fantastic aeroplane. There's a lot of argument for what we've got with the Spitfire or the Mustang. It's absolutely irrelevant. There were two different generations. The Mustang was designed with the lessons that were learnt were having built the Spitfire and operated the Spitfire in the early years of the war. The Spitfire was designed to be an interceptor, to go up and shoot down bombers and to land. It was very short range. That made it handful over Germany when people needed to escort bombers for bombing missions. The Mustang was designed from the outset to be a much lower drag aircraft, so it needed less fuel to glide along, and also it was absolutely jam-packed with the stuff. And so these aircraft could fly for up to 8 hours on the internal fuel, and of course they had external tanks too. They had a special consignment of strong tanks, bringing a ton of quality of beer. And that was a way of getting the beer to them. Very efficient, I would say. This particular aircraft has been a feature on the UK scene for many years. It was originally owned by Stephen Gray, known as Candyman Booth. Eventually passed to the old Flying Machine Company. It is now marked as Ferocious Frankie. It's named in honour of the wife of Wallace E. Hopkins, the pilot of this, who flew with the 374 Fighter Squadron.
Here it comes down low now from right to left. Good chance for a picture of this. I can show you to see that.
Bearing was also considered for use in Vietnam. It was a very, very successful airplane. It not only carried guns, it also carried a rock band, and it also carried a rock band. We're now to land using China as a great vertical. Of course, the fighter needs to be very agile, so if it is attacked, it's out to get inside the arc of the fighter's machine gun. people here along the seafront this afternoon as the tide goes out and the sun has come out as well, glinting off the crushed glass sea. Isn't that beautiful? As the Mustang comes in, its gun ports howling from right to left.
Nice, eh?
There are worse places to be.
There are worse places to be. This is wonderful.
And the that surely has to be one of the best sounds in the world. The Mustang pulls away over the swimming pool, over the castle, and straight up. And of course, it's always interesting when you do see a Mustang, a Hurricane, the Spitfire in the same show. You see that even with roughly the same engine, the same make, the Rolls Royce Merlin, all three aircraft sound different. Very, very, very different indeed.
And the Lancaster as well, of course, powered by the same engines. Not going to see it today, unfortunately, but we do have this wonderful Mustang, which more than makes up for it, as it comes across from the harbour side over the swimming pool. Oh, what a close view we're going to get this time as he throws it around the sky from left to right.
Some success, and he's been flying this aircraft on and off for a number of years now. You can tell, currently. It's looted out over St. Omen's Bay, out towards St. Omen, wiggling the wings. Does that mean goodbye? From the Mustang.